Everyone, this is Patty, NW Lady, 1949, and I'm here today with another baby album that I've made, again out of the Graphic 45 Little Darlings. I'm almost out of this paper, but my goodness, has it gone a long ways. I used a pre-made binder this time. Someone had given it to me and it was in my closet, and I decided, oh, what the heck, maybe I'll just go ahead and use it. It came with 12 chipboard dividers that had little tabs on them, so I'm thinking maybe it was supposed to be for like a yearly thing and those were supposed to be months, whatever. But I cut the tabs off of them and just used the insides. I put a ticket here on the end that says Little Angels. I put some lace on the outside and covered it with a Mod Podge. Sprayed it with Lindy's, as I did the canvas on the book. Front and back cover I sprayed with Lindy's. I made mini flowers and then added some Webster's Pages flowers. I did glossy accents really heavy over the Little Darlings banner. These flowers, let me see if I can get them up there so you can see. These flowers, like this one here, actually this is an old ironing board cover that I had salvaged, washed and dried, and cut apart with a tattered flower dye from Tim Holtz. And then I wet it down and pulled it apart to try to get it to fringe as much as I could or fray, and then dried it and then put Lindy's on it. I think they turned out really good. They look good on this kind of a book, but all kinds of doodads and whatever on this front cover. And then on the inside, let's see here, on the inside on the front cover I've done two pockets. And then I put very large mats so that the mommy can put good sized photos in this. The stamp around the corner is a Heidi Swapp's corner stamp. And there were two of them that came in the package with all these little cute little sayings on them. This just slides right behind the pocket. And like I said, I was using up the rest of this Little Darlings paper, so I had to be creative at different points, like with the three colors here, in order to have enough paper to make the book. This is a another stamp. Darn, I forgot to get the name of it again. So if you want to know what company this is, just give me a holler and I'll look it up, anything here that I've used. The ribbons, a lot of the ribbons are the snug hug, whatever it is, seam binding, and I sprayed it with the Lindy's to match the book. Oh, I love that seam binding. I wish I had bought it a long, long time ago. So if you're debating and you haven't bought the big rolls of white seam binding, do it today. I guarantee you will not be sorry. Another little tag. I did a corner punch. This is the Arches Corner Punch by Martha Stewart here on the edge of the paper here. A cutout from the paper, and then I cut this out with my Cricut, and then this is actually a rub-on that says thank heaven for little boys, and this was a little boy that was born. Another tag. I'm not sure I'm a fan of the three-ring binder, but this is going to a mommy who's probably never seen a book like this before. She does do some crafty things, but I thought for her in this instance, it would probably be very much easier for her to find placement and whatever. These three were cut out from the paper line, and then I used Tattered Angels, I think it is. Let me see here. Tattered Angels Glimmer Glam. And this one is in the Rockin' on Sunshine. And what it is, you can see it's got a high amount of glitter in the bottom of it. And so I just paintbrushed all the way around each one of the little baby's here, and it gave it this glittery, yellowy sheen. I kind of like that look. And then on this side, I have two more pockets and some large mats with some cutouts from the fussy cut from the paper line. And then another one. It's hard when you like embellishing and doing to try to keep it a little bit simpler for somebody that's not a scrapbooker and doesn't do this kind of stuff. I find I want to add more and more and more and keep trying to tell myself, no, 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 back up. Another tag. I love all these with all these cute little sayings on them. Advertisements is what they are, old advertisements. I did go in and I put some stickles wherever I could, like you'll see on the little boy here and on this side, just to give it a little bit of pop here and there. I fussy cut this one out and I popped him up. I popped him up with some cardboard. And then colored these flowers. I don't know what the bling is. All of these things were just stuff that I had on hand in my stash. And then when you go to this one, this is a cutout from the paper. I only did it on the three sides, so it left a pocket underneath for a little tag. Another punch, decorative punches here. Another tag. Very simple, slides underneath here. Come on, I'm doing it left-handed, I'm not a very good lefty. And another tag here. And then on this side, I called my daughter and I said, is this appropriate? Can I use a picture of a little girl in a little boy's book? Because I had this one cut out and I just love this picture. And she says, oh, Mom, you're overthinking it. Just do it. So I did it. And then I glittered her little shoes up. I put glossy accents on the bow and just a little glitter on the butterflies. This mat I just popped up over the frame behind, so she can put a picture here. Then on this side, there are six children in this family. Gabe is the new little baby, and he's the second little boy. And I wanted a spot, because I hadn't done anything like this for any of the other children, someplace where she could incorporate pictures of the whole family. So here, I made a little book, but instead of it being a pull-out book, I glued the last page down. I did put the ribbon binding in it, just like you would have with a book. But I popped this little guy up to be a holder to keep these pages from just falling out all the time. And then it says, my family and me and the little Cupid dolls. There's six of them. I thought that was very apropos, one for each of the kids. And then as you open the pages, each one has the child's name on it, and it has glitter on it, and it goes from the youngest to the oldest. And I figured that way there's a spot for her. She can take these little photo place markers out if she wants, and then just do a collage of pictures, or she can put one picture in, whatever she wants. But it is a place so that the whole family can feel like they're a part of this book. And then on the very last page, there's a place for my mommy and daddy. I thought that turned out cute. And then it just pops underneath to hold it in place. Another pocket here, and I took one of the pictures from the paper line, cut the circle, pinked the cheeks because I thought they needed pink cheeks. And I again raised this up on chipboard and put it on a mat with the pearls behind it. And it kind of is a place marker for a little tag here. And then there's a pocket here, so you've got a tag. Several tags here. This is a Martha Stewart ribbon front and back. And this comes with the peel-off tape on it, so you just peel the tape off and stick it down. Had this for quite some time, and I always forget about using it. Another tag with more stickles on it, plain on the back, just the little cupies across the bottom. And then another tag here, and they slide And there's plenty of room here that you could put a 4x6 photo on the back part with no problem at all. Usually I count because I'm always curious to see how many photos you can get in a book, but I didn't do it this time. But I know you can get at least 50 in here, maybe more. Okay, the next page is a little pocket. I love this piece of the paper. So I just cut the edges out. I put a little gusset on each side to pop it up a little bit. And glossy accented the baby bottle. Put some pink on all of their cheeks. And then up here in this corner, I had a stamp and it says, "Babies are such sweet beginnings." And this is, let me pull this up here so you can see it. This, see how it reflects? This is an embossing pattern. It's the only one I have from Lindy Stamp Gang. Oh my goodness, do I love, love, love this stuff. It just is very, very fine grit, and the wording just comes out wonderful. Definitely will be buying more of this. Then I made a little book. This is one sheet of paper, 12 by 12, just folded and cut so that it will make this little photo album. And I just ran the ribbon behind the front cover, then pulled it around in the back and tied it into a bow. Put a couple little beads on it and colored it with the Lindy Stamp Gang. And then you open it like this. Oops, let's get my butterfly out there. Open it like this so you have room for four photos here. Then you turn it around and you have room for four photos on this side. And I didn't know whether to glue the, still haven't decided whether I should glue the butterflies down. I'm afraid if I glue them down, then maybe it'll have a tendency to make them want to tear. And then I wanted it so that the pictures could go behind the butterfly, but it's no big deal. They can just press them down. So that's that. Then it comes around like this and then ties again. And I'm not going to be able to tie it on. Oh, we'll just leave it like that. And then it just slides down in this little pocket. On this side, I have a cutout from the paper that I only did on the three sides and left it so you could slide a mat underneath. And another mat here. And it slides down into the little boy here. I have him popped up on some chipboard as well. And I have glossy accented quite heavily his shoes and his little horn. And then I took and I cut a slit in the paper and didn't glue any of this part down to the chipboard so that I could slide my mats down underneath here. And I'm going to leave these mats out because I keep forgetting I want to wet these ribbons down and scrunch them up so they dry all scrunchy. I'm sure you've seen this before, but with this seam binding, if you dry it and scrunch it, you can get it to come out and look like this. And that's what I wanted here, and I keep forgetting, so I'll leave these mats out so I remember to do that. Okay, the next page. Pockets on the side this time. This is more of the paper, and I just put some little pearls on all the little butterflies to pop them up a little bit. And then here I have two small mats here. And then I have two very large mats here, front and back, with a little, I keep forgetting, I hope I don't get out of frame too much. I keep forgetting this camera's in a different spot today. And then this one. And then you can also put a big picture here. This was a flower someone sent me in a swap I did, and I'm sorry, I have no idea who made it. If you recognize it, let me know and I will certainly give you credit. I did take, and it was very, very tight, like this. And I took and sliced it down all the way and scrunched it so it would lay a little flatter. And then I put some stickles on it. And then these just slide behind the little flower to hold them. like this. And this goes like that. And then this one. And then this one. And then on this page, I have taken more of the Lindy's embossing and just embossed little angel and some stars and some little hearts around. Another popped up photo frame mat. Another cutout from the paper line that I put on chipboard and popped it up. Just simple, but yet it will be really nice when she gets the pictures in. And then on this one, I have just a place for a photo and then some journaling. And these I've had for so long. I was at Home Goods, which is TJ Maxx and Home Goods. And they had these, packages of four or five of them. And there's three in a package for like $1.50 or something. And so I've had this rattle forever. And I thought, oh, how perfect. I finally used the rattle. I made another little book here, but again, I adhered it right to the chipboard so that it stays in place. I put the ribbon closure. It does have a magnet closure on it, but I still, after I got the magnet in, I wanted to use this ribbon, so it's double duty. And it just folds out like this, and there's a place for, I think, 9 photos on this. Oops, I think it goes like this. And then it just ties. And so like I said, with all these little extra photo books in there, there's a lot of places for pictures. And then the last page, I was really desperate when I got here because I didn't have enough paper. So I took the front of the book, which is glossy, cut out this picture because this is the one I cut out for the front of the book. Absolutely love this. But then I still didn't have enough because I only had this little rectangle. So I took a strip here, a strip here, a strip here, and put the ribbons between them to make a big enough page. Cut out the mama and the baby, and then the for the baby here where I could put a note from me, and just left this as a pocket to slide these three little mats down underneath. This is such a gorgeous paper line. I think this is the third or fourth baby album I've made with it, but I mean, my goodness, look at those little darling faces. Just adorable. And then I had, come on, get in there, doing this left hand, I'm having a hard time here. I had these pretty little white flowers, and I just used some weathered wood distress ink and put around the edges, and it just made it the perfect color. Weathered wood is the perfect distress ink for this line. Works really well. Okay, that's it. The back is, let's get this up here. There we go. Back is just a piece of the paper, and I covered it all with an Eileen's matte Mod Podge stuff, which is very transparent, and it's not very heavy. When you have it on, you have a little bit of feel of something, but not too much. And again, there's my front cover. I really enjoyed making this. I think it'll be a great gift for her. I want to get it out in the mail to her now because the baby's, let's see, he was born the end of November, so a couple of months old now. So that's my book. Thanks so much for stopping by. Please leave me comments. I really love to read what you think. And if you have ideas or suggestions, be sure and leave those too. I just love to hear what other people are doing. If you're not a subscriber, I'd love for you to subscribe. Have a wonderful day, everyone. Bye-bye now.